Welcome back to Darkest Dungeon, everybody. My name is Baer. It's time. It's time! It's time! It's finally here! The belly of the beast. Your enemy is vast, sprawling, must be destroyed from within. I've built a team that I think is gonna work, and it's the McCall twins again, oddly enough. For some reason, it slipped my mind that the Abomination would not actually be able to team up with his Vestal, so instead, I've given him a Crusader. And honestly, I think that might end up working out better for me, especially considering this. We've been using this, or at least we had used this in a recent run. The Inspiring Cry ended up being a really, really effective stress heal. And of course, the Crusader is obviously really good no matter what anyway. But with this team in particular, I think it's going to work out quite well. Especially considering the trinket selection we've got to have here. So with the Man-at-Arms, I'm rocking something I've used as a combo a couple of times. The Flesh Heart Trophy along with the Ancestor's Signet Ring, gonna give him a ton of protection and defensive bonuses. The Crusader is gonna be rocking the Candle along with the Pen, taking a whole fucking bunch of stress damage as a result of that, which I'm worried about. The Peveril, our Legend Highwayman, is gonna be rocking Dismas's Head along with the Fuseman's Matchstick Trophy, so while he's not getting two trinkets that give him stress damage, he is getting Dismas's Head, which gives him 20%, which effectively is the same as what the Crusader is dealing with, so sort of sucks, but it is a huge damage buff. And man, unfortunately though, that's just not nearly as good as things like the Candle and the Pen. I think the Pen is honestly better than this, just because of that minus 10% max health. That is pretty strong. But then over on McCult, number two, do I need to... I don't think I need to change their name, do I? I kind of just like having them be the McCult twins, so no, that's good. I like that. Tome of Holy Healing, and Junia's Head, for even more stress damage on her as well. So they're all getting a bunch of stress damage piled on. We'll have to see if that ends up being a problem. For now, though, I think we're all set to go. Our weapons and gear are all fully upgraded. The guild has been visited. The campfire selection has been equipped. I think it's about time. I'm terrified. Yet again, I don't want to click the button. I've been told, though... Oh, you know what? I should probably fix these guys up as well. Okay, before we do this real fast, real quick, let's just commit to some treatment here. I owe it to these guys to fix them up after that cruel, cruel punishment. If you missed this episode, by the way, that was a lot of fun. Go back and watch that. Three Antiquarians. It was a good time. Okay. I think we're ready. Right? Yeah. Let's do it. The belly of the beast. Still embark. I gotta check one more time. Just that warning makes me so paranoid. But we've got everything set up here. We're looking good. We don't need the goddamn massive candles again, thank God. The talisman of the flame, so. Okay. In we go. Four campfires, and I am bringing every fucking ounce of food that they're gonna let me bring. Every single last one. 3.5 stacks, it looks like. I'm gonna bring probably just a full stack of shovels will do. I'm gonna bring a ton of this stuff as well. Maybe even two full stacks, actually. I'm gonna assume that this is something I don't want to be underprepared on. Full stack of torches. I gotta bring at least... Well, actually, you know what? I should bring way more torches, which means that I have to make a decision! Shit! Alright, maybe we're not gonna bring two full stacks of these after all. That might be a little bit overboard. Instead, let's just bring six of each. I wanna bring two stacks of torches, because I have a feeling that I'm gonna need a lot more torchlight. Along with the fact that I've got the Ancestor's Candle equipped, so I wanna make sure that I've got the means by which to keep that buff alive. If I've got a holy water in my inventory already, I suppose I might as well get the full stack of them just to be able to take advantage of that. And I guess herbs are probably pretty useful as well. There's I imagine some debuffs that are going to be at play. I don't think I need to worry about keeping inventory space for treasure here either. I'm pretty sure I can just go ahead and fill up on provisions and call it good. So this looks pretty strong to me. 24 torches, a ton of food. Shovels, anti-venom bandages, and then a few holy water and herbs. I assume I don't need keys here either. I'm just gonna go ahead and not bring any. Oh my god. Let's do it.
The interminable stone holds are but an antechamber. The creature is vast beyond measure, and must be battled from within. Step over the threshold, and let the terrible truth worm its way into your mind.
Ew, don't use the word worm! Oh, that's gross!
The gateless gate. A maddening aperture to realms beyond human understanding.
Oh, that's awesome! What? That's an anus. That's an anus right there. Oh, God. This is what we had to look forward to, huh? No wonder you guys wanted me to go in here. Look at this place. Oh, it's creepy. It's gross. Oh, look at those room layouts, too. Okay, so I don't know what the map looks like, but I know that what we're going for here, and it's, you know, it's pretty obvious given the name of the actual quest, is the belly of the beast. We're trying to get to the center. So, if at all possible, I'm gonna try to move just in the direction that I consider to be the center, which is probably, like, over in this area. Oh, unearthed, God!
Unbalanced.
Ah! Oh, flesh hounds. Okay, 34 hit points. Pretty strong resistances. Fetch gives them a stun and a move skill chance. Oh, goodness. Alright, let's try to get the back, I guess. Let's see how hard we're hitting with Peveril here. Not at all! What a wonderful start.
How quickly the tide turns.
Yeah, two crits for them and a dodge for us. Let's welcome to the darkest dungeon again, Bear Tappy. How you been? Nice to see ya. I ought to have just probably gone for a single target there, actually. And that's a okay, so there's the problem causer right there. 73 going up against 139. I think I'll take that risk. Let's try to get the back one again. Very good. Okay, next round's ours. Next round, we got it, baby. I can only move him back? What? Wait a minute. What on earth? You can only move the Crusader back. Since when has that been the case? Oh, shit. All right. Well, I might need to equip his Holy Lance then, because I definitely don't want him having to be relegated to the third and fourth positions there. That would suck. That would be really awful. Ha. Okay, well, that'll work, actually. Yeah, do that for me. Naturally. Oh, just no more crits on that, please. I was beginning to wonder whether or not those are just crits all the time forever. Let's see here. Try to whittle one down. There it is.
As the enemy crumbled.
Turn it around. Very good, very good. Crusader coupled with our Vestal now. I am going to go ahead and move her back to allow him the damage here. Good stress heal as well, and there's only two of them left, but I probably ought to just try to kill it. They're pretty quick, too, so they're going to get their damage in before we act, more likely than not. That is a painful move, and those little bits of stress are going to add up, unfortunately.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
I'm most likely going to have to commit quite a few rounds to stress relief from the Crusader every now and then. Oh, beautiful! I love the riposte on the duelist advance. This is so nice.
In radiance, may we find victory.
I think we're gonna go for judgment to try to get the kill here to get her healed up. Nice. Oh, look at that—the crit to finish it off. Lovely.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
Oh, I love, absolutely love the environment of this place. Handcrafted gory glory. It's beautiful. I also wasn't 100% sure whether or not I was going to be able to scout in this area, so I sort of just, instead of going for those sorts of advantages, I mostly just stuck with base stat improvements with those trinket selections. Otherwise, I might have been tempted to. Holy fuck! Ah! Get that thing removed! That's assist? I had assist once. It didn't turn into that. A white cell stock. Holy fucking hell. 25% protection. Look at all these resistances. Oh my goodness. That is gorgeous. It's horrifying, but that's so cool. Okay, let's see. Do I defend off the start here? Having a retribution maybe to start dealing some return damage? I'd love to mark him. I didn't realize we'd be dealing with protection here. That's a little unfortunate. We could also mark two targets, although that would put the Crusader in the back, of course. So maybe I'd, you know what? Maybe I should try to kill this thing. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. That seems pretty easy. Oh, that hurts, though. Blight. Okay, that's the problem. I see. I kind of want to kill that, but I also need to heal my Crusader, so I'm gonna... Oh, yes! Yay for being rewarded for making the right choice! Now, is this necessary? Maybe try to stun this thing real quick? It's not a terrible chance, but I might just want to take the damage, too. Oh, jeez, how did... It's attached to the floor and ceiling! How did you miss it? Bulging gaze also sounds sort of gross. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and remove that debuff here. It's pretty strong. Minus 20% damage. I'd also like to kill this thing. There we go. Advantage.
Give them no quarter.
Very good. All right. Well, that was easy. I have no idea what that thing was supposed to be for, but now it's dead. Yay. Let's try for the stun. Doesn't help too much when you've got an enemy that moves twice in the same round, but still, I mean, it's one less move that they've got to make. And we did stun him, so that's beautiful. Let's go ahead and try to heal up a little bit more. Nice. All right. Feeling good. Feeling pretty good here. This sort of seems like it's not really... Oh. Ah. Okay. This place I assume to be a move skill. So I guess we've just been getting kind of lucky as far as that's concerned. Although we kind of have a party that's going to be able to deal with that pretty effectively, I think. Hmm. So, if he's just gonna resummon this, and its sole purpose seems to be to do minor damage and move my party around, maybe I should just leave it alive. Although, it wasn't really that hard to kill. It only took like two shots. I'm gonna try to get rid of it again. That's probably a stun as well, I imagine, isn't it? It's only a debuff, really. Huh. Alright. It's not too shabby. We're still willing this thing away, too. The Crusader's really the only one that's dealing a ton of damage to him. Take care of that. There we go. Oh, shit. There's the Blight. Ow! Ooh! Oh, that hurts. Whoa, what the fuck? What?! That was an actual teleport? Where the hell am I? Okay. That's new.
A powerful blow.
They actually teleport me away. So I have to kill it before I get teleported away then? I love that the music didn't even change. Like, it's just basically the same thing here.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
That is so insane. So then the fight is still there. We can see it over there. Does that mean that we have to get back to that spot to finish it off, maybe? Perhaps that's what the labyrinth is all about, then, is just getting back through to that point. That's really interesting. I think I'm gonna get the Holy Lance equipped on my Crusader here as well. Very good.
Faint hope blossoms.
Although it is... I don't know.
Foolish horrors. Brought low and driven into the mud.
I think it's better than Zealous Accusation, honestly. You know what? I like this set of four better. Yeah, let's do that. Roll with that for a while. Switch these two back up. It might be campfire time. We've got four. And I don't know really what lies ahead of this. And we've got a little bit of stress. I think I'm gonna wait one more round, though. I'm gonna hold off on using torches as well, because I know we've gotta try to hold on to those as often as we can. It's a finite supply, even though it looks like there's quite a few right now. Another empty room, that's nice. And we're getting a lot of scouts, too. Although it may not be helping as much as I think it is. So let's keep heading back toward this, I guess. That's the only... I gotta keep my torch light above 50, though. There you are! Hey! I was just going back to see you! We found you! Hi, buddy! Oh, man. I missed you.
Who's a pretty boy? What's a good sist? Who's a good mama sist?
That's right, you are. So that's not that bad. The blight obviously is horrifying, but... if that's the worst he's got, then... yeah, that's not too scary. I can live with that. We've got the means by which to deal with it for the most part as well. Oh, he's got full health again. Yeah, so we're not carrying over progress, I guess, on these things. Unless there might... well, maybe there's more than one, actually. Maybe we have to clear through multiple cysts. Oh, god damn it! God damn it! That was fast, Jesus! Oh, fuck, that's more blight, I imagine. Yeah, oh, that's strong, too, Jesus. It's a move skill? Okay. That'll seem pretty straightforward as far as what they actually do. He's still got blight coming through. I think I just need to group heal again, though. 20 health across the team is working. He is not moved yet, but I don't think I'm going to be able to take him out. I don't want a grape shot here either. That's a little bit too much spread damage. Let's try to kill one of the back ones. Zealous would have actually been nice here, but I'll live with having the Holy Lance available. Great dodge as well. I'm definitely going to take the Antivenom here. And let's take a chance at a stun. Their resistances aren't incredible. Although I could... yeah, let's just go ahead and kill this one. That's way better. Stress heal, not really necessary. He's got about the same chance. Smite might kill it, though. Oh, shit. Every round, I mean, even against these little ones. I gotta be hoping for good results here, because these are all gonna be pretty tough. Everybody else's damage, though, is not bad. Oh, God. Oh, God. All right, it's definitely campfire time after this. Let's get her a little bit of individual attention. There we go. She's still marked, unfortunately, and there's our Holy Lance. And I forgot again that you can't target the front with the Holy Lance, but it's still good to have. I mean, we can get him to move forward by way of doing that as well. Oh, please leave her alone. Please leave her alone. Come on. These two alone should be able to take him out. He's going to be marked as well, so hopefully that'll change his priorities a little bit. Try to help her out as much as we can. I am going to try to heal her one more time, even though that might just be negated immediately upon the next round coming up here. Worth it! Nice! Very good. Alright, take him out. Not bad. Not bad.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
We have scouted a ton of this place, but holy hell, it is huge! Wow! Well, let's camp out.
A spark without kindling is a goal without hope.
So luckily, stress isn't really a huge problem right now. We probably want to prevent the nighttime ambush, but maybe we won't get ambushed in this place. It might be worth taking a gamble there to see whether or not that actually happens. We also have a couple of religious... party members here as well, so something like Prey might be worthwhile. Get some pretty significant protection buffs on these two. Chant is good as well, although of course we don't necessarily need it right now. The Man-at-Arms also has very good buffs for us. The Crusader has a couple of things that might be worth considering. The Zealous Vigil isn't really necessary at the moment, though. I'm probably gonna go with Prey. Oh, he's not religious. Okay, I keep thinking the Man-at-Arms is religious, but I brought him in with the Abomination before, so no, that's not the case. Crusader, though, that is a good buff. Now we'll take the Man-at-Arms. I think I'll probably end up going with Tactics and Weapons Practice. Just go ahead and do that. Could have done Clean Guns on our Highwayman, but meh.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted. And purpose is made clear.
Really like spreading out the campfire buff so everybody gets a little bit of benefit. Although, of course, there is an argument to be made to make the Highwayman as strong as possible as well. But for now, I like this. I think we're looking pretty good here. So looking at the layout, I can probably assume that this is the center, right? We're going all the way around, like, outside here. Since we started from here, I imagine it's probably going to be closer to this area. So I'm going to go this way.
The light. The promise of safety.
Hey, look! We found him again! Goody! So there must be multiples. I think there is, like, maybe just three, but I think they're, like, right there, and right there. And they must be three different ones. Do we have to kill them all? That's kind of crazy. Oh, he's got a heal? Alright, well luckily we didn't attack him that time. That's a buff. Oh, a protection buff as well. Ha ha. That sucks. That is not fun. Let me see here. I want to try to kill you, but I guess that's not going to happen this time. Let's go with retribution. I'm just assuming I'm going to get teleported away here, so let's just do as much damage as we can to the thing, I suppose, and take what it gives us. I don't have to heal here, actually. Judgment is maybe a better play. Well done! Yeah, look at that! Alright, I feel good now. It's really not- yeah, the damage there is not that bad. It's manageable stress. It's a debuff that I can easily get rid of, so I am not too worried about these guys. If this is the worst of it, then we have little to fear, I think. We've got a team that's actually able to deal with this pretty damn effectively as well. His bleed resistance isn't that good, and I can lower it with this as well. Bam! That's alright. Oh, I didn't get the debuff, though. Hitting him pretty hard. Okay, we're good, we're good. Still don't need to do Inspiring Cry necessarily, so let's keep the damage going. His white blood cell isn't back yet. I don't know, we might actually be able to kill this one. Maybe, just maybe. We end up getting maybe even below 100 hit points. That would be nice. Hey, look at that! And the bleed. Perfect. Oh, the debuff too. Now it begins.
Now the massacre begins! A devil's due!
Alright, here he comes. So let's try to kill it before he gets the teleport off. Let's make that the priority. If at all possible. Oh, great shot! Wow, maybe I don't need to. I could kill it. Let's find out. Okay, that could be problematic if the blight lands. Oh, shit. She's weak. Damn it. And she got targeted by that, too, which means nothing. Hooray! All damage. All damage on the fucking Sis. Let's go. Is this better than this? No, it's not.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
Sis down. Hell yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Health still looking good here as well. I'm gonna try to stun this thing. Although, fuck it. Worth a shot. Hooray! How did that move up? And it just had to, like, drag itself along the underbelly of this thing. That's disgusting. Nice shot.
A trifling victory. But a victory, nonetheless.
We actually got nothing at all for that. That's a little sad. Actually, we haven't gotten anything, have we? Yeah, we've gotten no rewards from this place. I'm really glad I kept my inventory open, then.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
Is this, like, the whole thing? It's just cyst after cyst. I'm okay with it. I mean, we've got a pretty effective system now for dealing with this thing, but I'm a little disappointed if this is all we got to deal with in this area. We got those little mutts, the flying dudes that we've seen now. That thing's easy to take care of, and that just leaves this dude, which by himself is really not that intimidating. I love the way he looked when I first saw it. I still do. I think this is an awesome character design, but it's really just kind of underwhelming compared to Darkest Dungeon Mission 2. But it is still early on, so I have plenty of time left to be surprised, maybe morbidly so. That damn protection. I think I'm correct in focusing down the white cell stock when I can, and I'm gonna go ahead and do it again, actually. Because as long as the Vestal and the Highwayman can combine to deal enough damage to take it out, then that ends up playing tremendously in our favor. So the Man-at-Arms and the Crusaders seem to kind of be able to take him out by themselves, too. So yeah, we've got a good split of the team here, although that unfortunately means he's got an opportunity to teleport. Luckily, didn't do it. Nice hit!
And power.
Good stuff. Keep it up. Well done. All right. That is helpful. And here he comes again. And that takes away a turn from the Cyst, so I mean, I'll take it. I'd love to be able to clear this one out without a teleport. Alright, the stress is starting to become a little bit of a concern, although we do still have three... Ooh, maybe I should try to go all in on this. 60 damage across all four of my party members would mean I'd have to average 15. Which is a little bit too much to ask, I think. Oh, lovely. Good for you. I'm gonna heal a little bit. I might have to get teleported this time around. I think I'm okay with that. But maybe next turn, revivify. Don't just make up words that give you hit points. That's a little bit of bullshit. He buffed up his damage as well, which is alarming. Our Man-at-Arms, honestly, I probably should just stop using the Crush. I should go with Retribution or Rampart. The damage difference there isn't worth missing out on the opportunity to, Oh, I think I'm gonna go for this. I'm gonna just try to go all in on the fucking Cyst. Oh, he's hurting me now, though. Alright, I need a group heal. Although a Judgment could work. Eh, it's not hitting him hard enough. I gotta take care of us. There's a much longer field of battle to trudge through here. I don't want to invest everything in just these moments. Alright, just one little bit more. Come on. We can still Holy Lance if he gets moved. There we go. I think I gotta focus on him. That Blight is strong. I'm running low on Anti-Venom as well, unfortunately. I'm definitely gonna use it still here. I'll just go for the stun, I think. The knockback on the Cyst, wow. Wonder what that does for this guy. That's a little interesting. I should kill it. Yeah, he might teleport me, so I should definitely kill it.
The greater the glory.
There we go. I was gonna take maybe an opportunity to stress heal there, but that's a little too greedy, I think. No! What? That's bullshit! Oh, that's total bullshit. Tell me I don't have to kill that Cyst again.
A blazing star is born.
That would be absolute nonsense. Are you kidding me? I might campfire here again. I know they've got a Cyst right there. I'm just gonna go ahead and do this.
Gathered close in tenuous firelight and uneasy companionship.
And let's go with Chant, maybe. Although, no, Prey was good still, yeah. I could do that. I also don't need to worry about the stress. I think his inspiring cry, honestly, might be enough to get us through it. So we don't need to do any of these. I'm gonna go with full buffs here. We're gonna go tactics, weapons practice, clean guns. Fully buffed up. Let's do it. Let's do it. We're gonna get this one. We're gonna get this fucking Cyst. Here we go. Oh, nice. Apparently we save our progress here. Good. Okay, then. That's gonna make this a hell of a lot easier. That, unfortunately, just made his chances a lot better. That sucks. Well, you know what? I'm gonna keep healing here. And now I'm done. Forever. Yippee! Retribution. I gotta stick with Retribution, I think. You know, I'd like to keep him marked. I'd like to keep their attention on him if I at all can. Unfortunately, the Flesh's Heart trophy didn't end up being the best choice here. Much rather would have taken some Blight resistance in order to prevent that massive damage that we've been taking from the Blight. Probably been the majority of the damage we've taken, honestly. So keep the white cell stock dead is more or less the name of the game here. And then we can hopefully just whittle this thing down. I don't necessarily want a defender, but I kinda like it here, just to prevent him from taking too much more from the Blight. Oh, stop it, man! Knock that shit off! Go for an attack! Let me hit you with retribution. There you go. Boom. Oh, there's another one though. Okay, well, if anybody's gonna get it, at least it's him, right? I'm happy with the man in arms getting the blight. I can focus on the healing for him. Nice shot. So we can live with that. Being out of anti-venom, we can absolutely live with that being the person we have to focus up with the healing. So all's well for now. I'm just gonna go ahead and let that run its course. Activate retribution again. Still has his defender for one more round. God damn it. God damn it! I wonder if he summons that with like the same— oh, nice shot. With the same sort of frequency as maybe the collector would. Oh, that's rough. That is rough. Stack the blight! Oh, that sucks. Okay, he's a little more intimidating without the anti-venom in my back pocket, I'll give him that. But at least we can effectively negate the blight damage we take up to that point. I'm gonna defend her again. I still think I'd like to— oh, and look at that too, 90% protection, that'll work. I still think I'd like to keep the attention on him. Oh my goodness. Knock it off!
Well struck.
Thank you! Not too shabby. Not too shabby. Oh, knock it off, man! Alright, we made some progress there. Holy shit, the flesh hounds now. Let's go! Let's do it. No dilly-dallying. We're fine. No more blight, please. No blight for anyone. Great group heal. No blight! No blight! Okay. I don't think that can actually blight, but I gotta say it just so I feel better about it. Crush! Shit. Don't need to do this. I'd like to stun one of them. Damn it. Oh, I need to reduce the damage here, man! He doesn't have his point blank shot either, so being moved forward, unfortunately, could be bad for you. Try the stun again. Trying to prevent those little bits of stress from piling up. Let's get the man-at-arms healed as well. Very good. The Vestal in this group is borderline necessary. I think the occultist would probably just fuck us over here, honestly. Oh, come on now. Speaking of fucking us over. Fucking us over against these two flesh hounds. Come on, Crusader. Take it seriously, man. This is the real deal. This is what was so threatening about this place from the start. These widow flesh hounds. Gotta love that. It's working so well. Okay. Okay, we're good. Just a little more damage from him, probably. Or not. How about 9? Or 13? I'll take it.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Alright, so I think I'm beginning to understand why this place is so hard to deal with. Because I imagine there's probably like 5 or 6 of these cysts spread throughout this dungeon. And the teleport seems to just send you to a random room anywhere. Oh, and that's scary. Ha, ha, that's new. Ah, I don't like this. This is potentially devastating. They've got a lot of blight. Ow, God. All right, we gotta focus. We gotta keep it together here. Let's see. He's got high stun resistance. He's probably gonna be the scariest opposition we face here as well. Do I want to try to defend, maybe? I think the polyps are going to be our top priority as well. So let me try to get this one in the back. Nice shot! Peveril! I love you! Alright, well at least we got the return damage before the stun landed, and we'll go ahead and take a group heal opportunity here too. Kumbaya moment. 16 to 30 is a shot at it. Oh baby, McCult! Yes! Wiped out two in the first round. Not bad, but his health is still a problem. Judgment would be okay here. Judgment from the Vestal that brings back a little bit of her health she's losing from the Blight, although I need to heal him one more time, so I'm gonna do it now. At least once more to hopefully avoid Death's Door in the next couple of fights, and then we'll just do that. Oh, baby! 44! Love it! Crusader will probably stress heal here, I'd imagine. Oh, great stuff! Nice!
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
Alright, there goes the Blight. Our heals are still... or our health is still looking okay. Another one! Oh my god, at least it's only one of these guys this time, but they're still... yeah, they're still just as capable. Pouring on that Blight. Okay, we've gotta kill this thing real soon. One more shot. The Judgment will probably be the play here again. Don't kill her! Don't kill her!
Blurred vision.
Ah!
The end approaches.
Oh, fuck. Okay, well... yeah, we gotta do that, obviously. Holy Lance is pretty damn good here, actually. Nice, there we go. No more Blight. For now, at least. Absolutely can afford to do that, although the Blight is gonna bring her down to zero again, but she is defended, so I mean, at least... oh god, but the stun! No! That's brilliant! The enemy is learning!
A killing blow.
Oh, fuck me! No, don't do this! Don't do this to me!
As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves.
Don't you fucking kill her, you savages! Mark the target! Let the highwayman take the heat! Okay? You can't get stunned again, at least. Got her off Death's Door. Oh my god. Wow.
Breath from becoming unwound.
One more turn on the Blight. I've gotta try to protect her. That's enough to survive the Blight to not take her down to Death's Door, but they did it again! Oh my god! They're bringing her forward too, and the stun! Oh my god! I'm gonna Holy Lance this one, I think. Please stop. Please fucking stop it!
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
Don't die. Come on, McCall, please! Oh, god, stop hitting her! Knock it off! Don't go first. Thank god. I can't Holy Lance this time, but she's alive again.
And now, the true test. Hold fast.
She got the stun buff. He's guarding her at least, and now we get one down. Oh, my heart's racing. Stop stunning me, please. Thank god. Okay. Defended. Maybe a stun. That would be nice. Thank you. Okay, please. Help her out. Help a poor girl out right here. She's still defended, so I can still afford to do this. These goddamn stuns from the antibodies are ridiculous. Very difficult to deal with. And they fucking hate McCall, too. They really don't want her around anymore. Nice shot. Oh my god. That hurt.
This expedition at least promises success.
Honestly, that fight was, like, more difficult than most of the stuff we've dealt with up to this point. That was scary.
Together, furtive and vulnerable. Rats in a maze.
Alright. Sanctuary. Unfortunately, the removal of or the buff for mortality debuffs does not apply to her. But... there's a stand tall that we could use. And that sort of seems worth it. It reduces stress on her as well. I'm gonna take that. And I think we might just go with double buffs again on the Man-at-Arms. Her health is an issue. I think we'll be able to take care of it within the next couple of fights, though. So let's go ahead and do that. There we go. All right. Let's keep moving. I'm gonna pop these holy waters, actually. Because I feel like we're pretty deep into this now, and I'd like to at least take advantage of those while I can. I've still got plenty of torches as well, so I'm gonna keep using those. There's another cyst! Haven't actually found this one yet, it seems, though, so... That sorta sucks. Same plan, though, same game plan. We'll judgment with the vessel here as well. Let's get it started. Don't get it twisted! Didn't get this done, alright. I'm kinda glad now, honestly, that these guys don't have anything that's too tough to deal with. Because if they did, given the results of that previous fight, maybe we wouldn't be nearly as well off as we are now. God damn it. Okay, that's not so bad. We've at least already been through here, and we've got the torches to get back in time. And I think we've been fighting that cyst, too. So maybe we'll be okay here. Keep popping torches, no worries there. Still got that one campfire as well. The more I'm actually playing this mission, the more I like it. I think it's a really smart idea. This is fun. I'm a fan. I like number three. Oh, this is all that's left here! And I missed him. I fucking missed him. And I dealt 8 damage, so now he's got 1 hit point and he's gonna teleport me. Now good, alright. Hooray! Well done, guys!
Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
Look, if they're getting triumphantly proud from that, then I think that we had a bigger problem from the get-go, didn't we? And a little bit of an ego issue. Alright, I'm gonna try this out. Still not 100% sure where we're supposed to be going, but this looks promising. This is a lot more potential for, blight here as well, so let's try to kill these two first. Always on McCault, God! Leave the poor woman be. She's had enough. She's seen it all. The antibody, I still kind of think might be a bigger threat, though. Just because of that stun. Potentially devastating. Let's do that. Violent hack, that's new. I think I'll just kill you. I think I'll just murder you! How's that sound?
Impressive.
Thank you.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Okay. Well. Am I going the right way? I'm kind of worried I'm not now. Maybe I need to be, they're all, like, guarding this middle area. Maybe it's here. What am I supposed to be finding? One lotus beacon, or locust beacon. Where do I need to go? I feel like there should be... Like, I should be able to piece together what the... where the destination is based on this info. This doesn't look right. I'm gonna go here. Just out of curiosity. And there's another cyst! Okay. That doesn't really bode well for me, actually, if I don't rightly know what I'm doing. If I don't know whether or not I really need to clear through this thing. Sort of seems like it might be a waste. That's fine. Nice!
Masterfully executed.
Good stuff. Yeah, we'll do that too. Come on, McCault! Your accuracy isn't that bad. I should heal with her, though, honestly. I really ought to be healing with her. Oh, yeah, that's some big damage. Honestly, that might have set me back a ways, having passed up on that opportunity to heal with her right then. Try it again.
A singular strike.
Mm-hmm. Well done. Oh, geez. I am really worried now that I'm, like, wasting my time here trying to kill all these cysts. I was throwing shade about it earlier, saying this isn't so tough, but I'd much rather, of course, not have to kill every single goddamn flippin' one I see. So hopefully that's gonna be a possibility here in the future. I'm doing well, though, as far as, like, getting our health back. It's actually sort of working in our favor here. Whittling this one down pretty effectively, too. The Highwayman has done his fair share, just critting every single new white cell stock that shows up. Let's keep that pattern up. Oh, the knockback, though. Okay. Minimal damage, probably a move, all right. Do I want to do that? It's got a pretty high bleed resist. I think I'm gonna do this followed up with the Holy Lance. Get him marked. I should be doing that more, actually, now that I've got this equipped. That's a pretty sweet combo move. Okay, still gotta keep the focus on our Man-at-Arms. Luckily resisted that Blight. Very good. Not too shabby. Oh, she's weak again. Maybe I can get a Defender going. Great stuff, yes! Oh, that's so helpful. Alright, let's do the Lance one more time here. Convenient. Very convenient. Haven't really been hitting him that much, though, unfortunately. Oh my god! Gets a return here, very nice. My wounds are mounting. I gotta remove that debuff as well. We've got all these herbs sitting here. I might as well do it. This, you know what? I'm gonna keep doing that. Yeah. Against the cysts, especially. Advance plus Holy Lance. And I don't have to kill this one yet, knowing that even if I get teleported here, actually, it's really not that big of a deal. This one's already at least quite weak. Really glad I healed him there. Very good. And a Holy Lance will probably do it.
Their cursed champion falls.
Very nice. Hopefully more healing opportunities here. Please stun it. That would be beautiful. And believable was the word I was going to go for, but also true. Oh my god, what is happening? This is also not where I'm supposed to go. Son of a bitch. Oh, I am worried now. I am quite worried now. I don't know where to go. I guess not to the middle. Maybe I should go somewhere else. Certainly seems wise at this point. We're gonna defend our Highwayman. I'm a little worried about this. Although, you know what? Actually, she's marked. And I'm much more worried about her dying. Let's all heal. Not that well, unfortunately. And I might have to campfire again here, actually. Bad stuff! Oh, shit. I needed that numbers advantage. He can move forward. That's okay. I'd much rather him take the crit damage anyway. He's protected. Also has pretty good move resistance. Won't be able to stun you. Hopefully I can kill this one. Nice. Still got my riposte active as well, and let's go ahead and do that. It's not as good, but it moves her back. May not be that helpful. Oh god, they hurt! Great damage. But I need to heal so much. I need to heal so fucking much. Even with her heal buffs, we are still falling pretty damn far behind here. Okay. Need a couple turns of just really good stuff. Already here, nearly have the damage. Almost had it there, too. I think I'm going to take an opportunity for the stress heal from the Crusader and the big heals from the Vestal. Another one! So damn helpful right now. Crusader stress heal, going our highwayman, there we go. Alright. Stop it. Stop it! It's actually fine. It's actually totally fine. Worked out in my favor, in fact. I'm gonna maybe try to stall this for one more round. I honestly think I can get away with it, and I kind of need it. So let's do it now. One more round here. I'll use Defender on our Man-at-Arms to protect the Highwayman one more time. Okay, yeah, that was definitely the last round we could do it, but luckily we'll be able to get away with at least one more heal. Fine by me. I wish I could stall, so I'm going to. The Crusader's gonna have to finish him off, I guess. But we can have the Vestal go with the group heal, ideally, before he moves! Damn it! Okay, I think I just got ourselves some reinforcements, didn't I? Unless I judgment with the Crusader, or with the... I think I'd rather do this. I'd rather do this than risk the reinforcements, because that could totally fuck me over. Hmm. I'm gonna go down here. And maybe even just go further from the door? I don't know. I kinda wanna- backtrack, honestly. And just see if maybe if I go this way, if I'll find even more paths going over there. Cause I know I've gone down here and that's a dead end. I've got tons of torches as well. I'm gonna try this. I really hope this isn't, like, the goal. Otherwise, I'd feel really silly. In fact, I almost want to go check it out just to make sure. But it'll almost certainly be another cyst in this hallway, given the nature of the hallways preceding it. So I don't know if it's worth it. I don't know what that is. I don't know what's in this room. It might just be another big waste of time, honestly. I have no reason to believe it's not. So I'm gonna keep going over here. Torchlight isn't really dwindling that quickly here anyway. We're adding a little bit of stress, but it's manageable. I'm gonna go down here, I'm gonna go right, and if this is a dead end, then maybe we'll go try to reinvestigate the center or something. I have no clue. I have no clue where I'm supposed to go. There's no real indicator either. We're getting a lot of scouts, but it's still not really clearing anything up. Oh! I'm getting a lot of those through this. But it's good to be reminded that that can happen and be terrified of it now. Hmm. The fact that there's enemies here unfortunately does nothing for me. It's not really clear anything up. I might defend her here. Oh, we've got our Man-at-Arms up at the front for some reason. That was silly. Alright, small chance, but I'll take it. Yeah. Knocked him back. Holy Land, sure! That works. And the Highwayman could set us up with a Duelist Advance here too, or we could try to get the kill on this one, which is maybe a little better, but they deal the same damage, so fuck it. Fuck it all to death! That was what I was worried about. Okay, he is hurting something fierce. Oh, the stun too! Keep the focus on the Man-at-Arms. Everybody else's health is looking okay. It's looking manageable. He's still got his riposte active, so let's just do that. Although the bleed could be better on him. The numbers one more time here. That's okay. Jeez. Jeez. He lives! And our Crusader, unfortunately, is not that effective here. Alright, so we have to have that set up properly. I've got to be aware of what the, Oh, goodness! Nice shot! I've got to be aware of what the enemy lineup looks like before I try to set up the Duelist Advance Holy Lance combo. I ought to focus the individual targets with those heals, too. It's a little silly of me to try to group heal here. Jesus! That's better. Twice as effective for one person, and now we can do this! Yay! Well done. Well struck. Okay, that didn't help at all. What if this is the room? But how am I to know that? How am I to know? I can assume that we're looking at, like, dead ends here, right? Because this goes nowhere, this goes nowhere, that goes nowhere. This could be the middle. I'd much rather know that for myself now. It looks like it's, you know, like, geographically speaking, it looks like it's about the center of this map. So I'm gonna go look at the center of this map, and if that's not where I need to be, then so be it. But I will be happy for having checked. And I will feel silly for having walked by it when I was adjacent to it right back then. That'll feel dumb. But it's okay, because I had to know. I had to go find out for myself. Okay. We're gonna camp here, even though it's risky.
A moment of respite. A chance to steel oneself against the coming horror.
I know it's entirely possible that I am just, camping out for yet another useless polyp fight. But let's find out, I guess. There goes four campfires. And we're all feeling okay. Wait a minute, no polyp here? No polyp. Okay. This is not where I'm supposed to be, but it is scouting something. And it's a connection to a room that may also not have anything to do with what I'm supposed to do. But I'm gonna go this way anyway, because fuck it. Let's just keep trying, man. Maybe one day... Oh, it's this guy! Oh, good! Oh, good, I was wondering when he would show up. Yay, and he dodged my attack! Oh, fun! Oh, how fucking fun is this now? What is happening? Alright, we got two riposts at least, and now... Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Alright. Let's assume he's gonna hurt. That was pretty effective, though. Actually, did quite nicely. Okay. Huh. Let's keep doing this. Yep. Looking good here. I'm gonna defend our Vestal. Give him some more protection. I think that'll be okay. He's still got his riposte active. Missing everything here. We've actually only dealt damage from return strikes, but it has been working. So let's keep it up. I can't Holy Lance here either, which sucks. Yeah, I'm gonna do this again. We actually landed a shot on him, yay! Why can I not do anything with you? Now our man-at-arms is back to full health, holy shit! Look at this! Maybe this is what we needed after all. Oh my god, damn! Yeah! Oh, look at this! A little confidence boost at the end. Or what I hope is close to the end. Perhaps, maybe.
Monstrous size has no intrinsic merit, unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
Is this the end? Tell me. Well, it's really dark. Another cyst! And I don't think I've found a cyst in a room yet. So, there's that. Mislead myself into thinking that maybe things have changed here. Maybe we've made some progress and are actually going to do something now. Stop missing your judgment! God damn it! I don't know if it's worth it to try for the stun of the Crusader there. He's the one dealing the bulk of the damage for us, so maybe I just try to stick with that. I also want a Duelist Advanced Holy Lance combo again, especially, yeah, in this fight in particular, that move combo is really effective, so let's try to do that more often. Because he can Holy Lance the Cyst as well, which is really nice. Plus, he's got that riposte active now. The front two have riposte active. Not anymore, but still. Half the team, at least. Summon's fine. I could defend our man-at-arms, which actually seems like a good idea, considering that Blight's going to be pretty damn devastating. All right. He's hurting. He's landing some shots. I'm getting a little concerned now. Get that combo again. I'll Retribution here. That'll do. They are getting what they want out of this. Ah. Ah, oh God. Owie. Yeah, I'm kind of scared right now. They are kicking my ass all over the place. Great Holy Lance. That Blight really hurts. Okay, the Crusader has got to be the focus of heals here. I'd love for him to focus on our marked targets, but I guess he's not going to do that. Still the same damage, basically, right? Even a lower damage modifier, actually. Nice. Good crit. My god, that is ridiculous. Totally ridiculous. Let's do that. Change based on need. 16 damage per round is just ridiculous. I think I'm going to go ahead and group heal. I'm going to assume that he's going to be brought to death's door here because there's not a lot I can do about it. Thank you for resisting the Blight at least. Fucking hell. Jesus. All right, we need a crit. Can't defender him again. We can do a retribution, though. This cyst is proving much more difficult to deal with than the others. Oh, we can keep him off death's door here. Nice. All right. Well, very good. That's much better. They spent two turns healing here, so we're at least in decent shape now. Hopefully we can kill this one. Damn, minimal damage. That should be return damage. Okay. Wow, we're getting hit hard. Stop that! God damn it! He has full health and 30% protection now. Are you kidding me? Oh my god. I gotta try that. Yeah. Great heal. Oh my god, this one. Is this not, like, it seems like it's more difficult than the ones we've had up to this point. Or maybe they're just getting a lot of RNG's favor here. Oh, please! 1 point of damage! Come on now! Man-at-Arms at least is looking pretty good. You've gotta be kidding me. Don't you dare fucking let him do anything. You son of a bitch, game. I will be so salty. No! Okay, maybe it's acceptable. Holy Lance might still get him. I need those bits of damage too, and our stress is starting to pile up even more! Thank God! Okay. There we go. Two riposts, but a lot of damage there in our Highwayman as well. Let's go ahead and do this. We'll keep the Crusader protected, and we'll keep our Highwayman available for the riposte. Keep that defender alive. Please don't resummon immediately. Maybe bleed it? 7 to 13, 7 to 13, 86, 86. Yeah, I'm going to take this shot. Very good. We're finally able to hit this goddamn thing now, too. That's all right. He's got one more turn here. I should heal. Yeah. Group heal might have been better, though. That's perfect. Oh, the resolve check coming in soon, though. And his damage has been seriously debuffed. I didn't even realize that, and I've got herbs as well. Yeah, let's go ahead and get rid of those, and let's do this. I only need... Yeah, this is gonna do it. Beautiful!
Perhaps the turning point.
Okay, I'd love to try to stun for at least a round or two to try to heal up a little bit more. His stun resistance is high, though, so I might not get it off. Absolutely worth trying for, though. 12 damage on the stun crit. Holy shit. And maybe we can get the Crusader to relieve a little bit of that stress off of the Man-at-Arms as well. That would be really nice. Oh, never mind. He's dead. All right, fuck it. This is it! Oh! We did it! Yeah! Nice! I didn't even realize. The belly of the beast has been conquered! So perhaps that cyst was a little bit tougher than the others after all. Very interesting. All right. Well, we made it through. Darkest Dungeon Mission 3 complete. And some scurvy for our trouble. That was fun. I like that one.
At last, the twisted heart of the world is laid bare. For sword or supplication.
The Blood Moon returns. Kill one heart of darkness. At last, the twisted heart of the world is laid bare for sword or supplication. Look at all those torches. Beautiful. Okay. Well, what happens now? Four more heroes, permanently emblazoned with the mark of success. This is a short mission. Oh, that's interesting. Well then, we'll have to see maybe what our options are. For now, thanks for watching The Belly of the Beast. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time.